You took the perfect shot, but then you zoom in and it's a blurry mess. Yeah, it's camera shake, but don't worry because Photoshop can help you to fix it. Let me show you how. Alright, here is the photo and it looks totally fine, but when we zoom in, you can see clearly a motion blur. It's a classic camera shake and we want to fix this. To fix this, we need to figure out two things. The first one is the angle of the blur and the second one is the length of it. For that, you can use the ruler tool. Let's zoom in. Zoom in on a sharp edge that got blurred just like this and draw a line along the direction of the blur like this. Okay, now look at this carefully. This is the angle. A for angle, it's -129.8, that means around 130, -130, and the length is around 15. Remember these values because we'll need them. Okay, now copy the layer by pressing Command and J or Control and Z on Windows, right click and convert this layer into a smart object. This will keep everything non-destructive. And then go to Filter, Sharpen, and click on Smart Sharpen. And now in the Remove drop-down, select Motion Blur because we want to fix the motion blur here. Okay, and now enter the angle. Our angle was -130°. Okay, and you can see the angle here. It's in this direction. And look at this direction. Okay, let's zoom out. I think it's okay. And now for the radius, use around 15. We have measured it. Okay, let's go with around 15, but feel free to experiment with these values. You don't need to be exact. Okay, and now slowly and gradually increase the amount to fix the shake. Okay, don't overdo it. Take your time and find which is best for your photo. I think around 340 is looking good for this photo, or around 330. So let's zoom in and see. Look at the eyes. This was the before. Look at the shake. And this is after. It's a lot better. And we can change the value later if we need, because it's a smart object. So when you're happy, hit OK. That's done. Let's zoom in. Let's zoom in on the eyes and see the before and after. This was the before. Look at this. It's total blurry. And this one is after. Look at this. This was the before and this is after. It looks a lot clearer and I think it's better than before. This trick can really save a good photo, but my honest advice, always try to take multiple shots to avoid camera shake in camera, not just in Photoshop. And also you can use higher shutter speed. And that's it. I hope you love this video. If you did, hit the like button, leave your comments, and don't forget to subscribe.